morning, everybody joining us on the St. Anne's Facebook page. It's wonderful to welcome you to our worship today. We pray that as you worship where you are and as we worship where we are, we will all experience God's peace and God's presence with us at this time. If you'd like to follow along with the service, then the service sheet is posted just below this video on the Facebook page. We begin our service together. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Grace, mercy, and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you. Thank you. We say together the prayer of preparation. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Rachel is going to come and bring us our first Bible reading this morning.
Our first reading is from Philippians 2, verses 1 to 13. If then there is any encouragement in Christ, any consolation from love, any sharing in the Spirit, any compassion and sympathy, make my joy complete, be of the same mind, having the same love, being in full accord and of one mind. Do nothing from selfish ambition or conceit, but in humility, regard others as better than yourselves. Let each of you look not to your own interests, but to the interests of others. Let the same mind be in you that was in Christ Jesus, who, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God as something to be exploited, but emptied himself, taking on the form of a slave, being born in human likeness, and being found in human form, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Therefore God exalted him and gave him the name that is above every name, so that at the name of Jesus every knee should bend, in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Therefore, my beloved, just as you always obeyed me, not only in my presence, but much more now in my absence, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. For it is God who is at work in you, enabling you both to will and to work for his good pleasure. This is the word of the Lord.
As we heard there in the reading, St. Paul encourages the early churches to have the same mindset of Christ, valuing others above ourselves in humility. As we come to our time of confession this morning, let's confess before God when we have been proud or intolerant of others. Let's receive his forgiveness and commit to living a new life in the steps of Christ. As we sit, let us pray our confession today. our Lord Jesus Christ. The first commandment is this: Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is the only Lord. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second is this: Love your neighbour as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Amen. Lord, have mercy. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, Jesus Christ, to save us from our sins, to be our advocate in heaven, and to bring us to eternal life. Let us then confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments and to live in love and peace with all people. We say together, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate faults. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and lead us in life eternal. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The Church's prayer for today. O Lord, we beseech you mercifully to hear the prayers of your people who call upon you, and grant that they may both perceive and know what things they ought to do, and also have the grace and power faithfully to fulfil them. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and for ever. Amen. Rachel will bring us our gospel reading for today.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. When he entered the temple, the chief priests and the elders of the people came to him as he was teaching and said, By what authority are you doing these things? And who gave you this authority? Jesus said to them, I will also ask you one question. If you tell me the answer, then I will also tell you by what authority I do these things. Did the baptism of John come from heaven, or was it of human origin? And they argued with one another. If we say from heaven, he will say to us, Why then did you not believe him? But if we say of human origin, we are afraid of the crowd, for all regard John as a prophet. So they answered Jesus, We do not know. And he said to them, Neither will I tell you by what authority I am doing these things. What do you think? A man had two sons. He went to the first and said, Son, go and work in the vineyard today. He answered, I will not. But later he changed his mind and went. The father went to the second and said the same, and he answered, I go, sir, but he did not go. Which of the two did the will of his father? They said, the first. Jesus said to them, truly I tell you, the tax collectors and the prostitutes are going into the kingdom of heaven ahead of you. For John came to you in the way of righteousness, and you did not believe him. But the tax collectors and the prostitutes believed him. And even after you saw it, you did not change your minds and believe him. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Let us pray. Father God, we pray that our hearts will be open to receive your message of love for us today. In your name we pray. Amen. Amen. We so often get it wrong, don't we? Even those of us who follow Jesus a long time, we slip into the wrong thinking and we give the wrong impression, the wrong message to those outside the church. To those of us in the church, we can think that we're accepted by God by living good and respectable lives, or by the very fact that we come to church. Those of us not in church think that we're excluded from God because we've done wrong things or failed to go to church. Both of these things are the opposite of the Christian message. God is our Father. We are his children. Parents of children don't love their children because they do the right things, or reject them when they do bad things. Parents love their children because they love them, because they love them, because they love them. The only way we can lose the love of a parent is if we fail to accept it, if we reject it and walk away. In our reading from Matthew today, Jesus challenges the Jewish temple leaders about their failure to accept God's love by rejecting him, Jesus, as God's son, God's Messiah. Their thinking had gone wrong. They thought that they were God's children because they did all the right stuff, because they were religiously observant. Tidying their room, not walking out into the road, sitting up at the table are all good ways for children to love their parents. But they are not the reason that their parents love them, and their love isn't dependent on their performance of doing those things. All they need to do is accept the love of their parents that is always there for them. The tax collectors and the prostitutes that Jesus talks about in the reading we heard had failed to perform the religious tasks that would help them love God, but they had succeeded in recognizing Jesus as sent from God, and large crowds followed Jesus. Like the first son in the story that Jesus told, they had said that they wouldn't go and work in the fields. They had failed to obey God's law in many ways. But in the end, they did go. They accepted Jesus as God's son, as sent from God. Whereas the religious leaders of the day were like the second son in Jesus' story. They said they would go. They lived religious lives. But in the end, they failed to go. They failed to see that Jesus was God's Son. It's easy for us all to get this wrong, so as politicians, be clear. No matter what you have done in your life, whether you've been to church one time or 1,000 times, you can come to God today. You can receive his love for you today. I'll say it again in case there's anyone who hasn't heard me right or if I've said it wrong. Whatever you've done in your life, whether you've come to church one time or 1,000 times, you can come to God today and receive his love for you today. You don't need to prove yourself to him. He loves you because he loves you because he loves you. You can come to him and begin walking the road of his forgiven child as his disciple. The only way that you can miss out on God's love for you today is by failing to reach out and take it, because it is there for you. All you need to do is reach out and accept it. And so for those of us who maybe have been more, we need to give this message, and we need to not give the wrong message or give the wrong impression to those who are not in the church. We need to let people know who have made mistakes in their lives that God accepts them and God loves them when they come to him. This is the message that we have to give. I'll leave a moment of silence for us to accept God's word to us today. Whether we need to accept that God loves us because he loves us because he loves us, or whether we need to take on that challenge or challenge our own thinking that there is anyone, not in the church, who can be accepted by God immediately when they come to him, and that we have the responsibility to tell of God's wonderful love to all we meet. A moment of quiet together. Let us join together and declare the wonderful love of God. Do you believe and trust in God the Father, source of all being and life, the one for whom we exist? We believe. Do you believe and trust in God the Son, who took our human nature, died for us and rose again? We believe and trust in him. Do you believe and trust in God the Holy Spirit, who gives life to the people of God and makes Christ known in the world? We believe and trust in him. This is our faith. This is our faith. We believe and trust in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Let's come in prayer to God our Father who loves us. In the power of the Spirit and in union with Christ, let us pray to God our Father. Father God, we thank you that no one is excluded from your love who comes to you in repentance and faith. We pray, Father, that we would know your love for us in our hearts today, and that we would go out from this place with this message that no one is beyond or excluded from your love. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Father God, we lift to you our world. Lord God, we lift before you our nation. We pray for your blessing and your healing to be upon us. We pray for all those who are part of a local lockdown in their area, and we pray for their strengthening of them. We pray, Lord, that you would bless all our leaders and all who work in healthcare and all who are seeking to work towards a vaccine for coronavirus. We pray, Lord, for your blessing and your wisdom upon them all in their work. We pray, Lord, that you would bless our leaders today, that you would help them make the right and wise decisions for the protection of us all, particularly the most vulnerable. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We lift before you our church schools and all schools in this area. We pray, Lord, for all who teach there, for all students who attend. We pray for love to flow between them. We pray, Lord, for your blessing upon them and your protection upon them. Lord God, keep them safe and keep them loving as they learn together. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For our bishops and our diocese, for all church communities in this town of Worksop, we pray that we may all be united, Lord, in sharing your love and light to those in our communities and caring for any who are vulnerable. We particularly lift up before you, Lord, those who were ordained deacon and ordained priest in Southminster this weekend. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We lift up especially those known to us who are ill or suffering at this time, and for any we know who are bereaved or any who have asked us to pray for them. In a moment of silence, we lift those who we know before the Lord in prayer. Let us commend all who, for whom we have prayed to the love and protection of God. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen. Thank you so much, everyone, for joining us this morning. This afternoon we have our services of Ignite, our children's church in the hall, and our cafe church, St Anne's at 4, returns at the back of church again at 4 o'clock. Look forward to seeing you there, or do pray for us. Next Sunday will be our annual parochial church meeting as part of our morning worship here in church. The 2019 annual report has been emailed out to everyone on our church mailing list. If you've not received that, or if you prefer a paper copy, then there are some on the table as you leave church today. Do join us for that service if you're able, or if you're not able to be with us here in church, do email Rev Dave, who can give you some Zoom details. You'll be available to join that service via Zoom, and if you're joining us on Zoom, you will be able to take part in the meeting as well. So do join us either in person or online for our church meeting next Sunday. The following Sunday, the 11th of October, will be our Harvest Festival service. This service will be ticketed, so we know how many people are coming, so we can make preparations for that here in church. Please buy your tickets online via the link in the parish email, or if you don't receive the parish email, just let me know on the door at the end of this service that you would like to attend church next week, and I will take your name and there'll be a space prepared for you. We will be collecting a harvest offering of non-perishable groceries for Hope here in Worksop. Please drop those off at our services in church next Sunday, either at 9:30 or at 4 o'clock, or during our weekly open church, which is on Fridays at the moment, Friday, October the 9th, between 9:15 and 10 a.m. The church is open. We begin with live stream morning prayer at 9 o'clock, then it is private prayer from 9:15 until 10 o'clock. But a week on Friday, please do come at that time to drop off your harvest offering at the back of church. Is it anybody's birthday here today or in the coming week? No one this morning? Anyone online? I think there's probably a delay on the stream, actually, so I wouldn't know if they were commenting, to be fair. Ethan's birthday tomorrow. Thank you, Rachel. Give him our best wishes. Let's all wave our support to Rachel in everything she does for us. Happy birthday, Ethan. Going to come now in our service to celebrate God's love for us by sharing Holy Communion together. We're sharing Holy Communion by receiving the bread only at this time. I receive the wine on your behalf. After I've said the communion prayer, I will say, brothers and sisters, the body of Christ, if you will respond, amen, at that time. I will then come to the front of the church here, and Peter will release you from your pews to come and receive communion one by one at the front of the church. There is sanitizer here on the front pew, if you would use that as you come. If you come forwards wearing your mask, if you're on this side of the church, stand around here. I will then serve you the wafer. After I've served you, please do remove your mask and focusing on the cross and on the east window. Jesus, before us, we receive the wafer as our communion with God. Then if you return to your seats via the side aisle, the same for you on this side. If you stand here as you come, I'll receive the wafer. Focusing on Jesus on the cross, we receive our communion. And then, if you return to your seats via the side aisle. We share God's peace together. Christ is our peace. He has reconciled us to God in one body by the cross. We meet in his name and we share his peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Thank you. Let's wave to one another God's peace. Brothers and sisters, the Lord is here. His Spirit is with us. Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give thanks and praise. It is always right to give you thanks and praise. God our Creator, loving and faithful, holy and strong. You made us and the whole universe, and filled your world with life. Holy, holy, holy. You sent your Son to live among us, Jesus our Saviour, Mary's child. He suffered on the cross. He died to save us from our sins. He rose in glory from the dead. Holy, holy, holy. You send your Holy Spirit to bring life to the world and clothe us with power from on high. And so we join with angels to celebrate and sing. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Father, on the night before he died, Jesus shared a meal with his friends. He took bread and thanked you. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." After the meal, Jesus took the cup of wine. He thanked you and gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new promise, of God's unfailing love. Do this in remembrance of me." Jesus Christ has died. Jesus Christ has died. Jesus Christ is risen. Jesus Christ is risen. Jesus Christ will come again. Jesus Christ will come again. Father, as we drink this wine and eat this bread and remember the death and resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ, send your Holy Spirit that we who share these gifts may be fed with Christ's body and blood. Amen. 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 Pour out your Holy Spirit on us, that we might love one another, work for the healing of the earth, and share the good news as we wait for his coming in glory. Amen. 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 For honour and praise belong to you, Father, with Jesus your Son and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen, amen, amen. As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Jesus, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Grant us your peace. Draw near with faith. Receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave for you, and his blood which he shed for you. Eat and drink in remembrance that he died for you and that he lives for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Amen. Brothers and sisters, the body of Christ. Amen.
Thank you.
brothers and sisters, the blood of Christ. Amen. Lord of creation, whose glory is around and within us, open our eyes to your wonders, that we may serve you with reverence and know your peace at our lives' end. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We say to him, Father God, thank you for giving us your only Son, Jesus Christ, so that we might not die, but have eternal life. We have shared in his body and his blood. Now as we go from here, may we share his life with the world and live as your new creation. Amen. God bless you all, whatever this week holds for you. If you remain seated as we finish our service, Peter will come and release you pew by pew, and I look forward to greeting you outside the exit door, which is at the front of the church at the moment. God bless you all. Christ, whose glory is in the heavens, fill this house and illuminate your hearts, and the blessing of God Almighty, Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ.